Welcome to Be Kind, Don't Rewind. I am one of your hosts. I'm Kimberly Wilson. This is my co-host.
Ogre. Oh, hello.
We are excited to start this endeavor where we're going to rewatch old movies that we remember fondly from our childhood or adolescence and then basically crap all over them and rip them apart because when you watch them as an adult, they're way different, we've learned.
That's a true story.
Yeah. So we're going to give you a little sneak peek of how we're going to do this by showing you the thing that Walt Disney used to give a sneak peek to theaters prior to releasing. What we're going to do is our first movie, the 1955 Disney original Lady and the Tramp. So you ready to get on this, Ogie?
Oh, I'm already on it.
He's on it like a... Never mind. That's probably going to be an inappropriate analogy. So we're just going to start this trailer.
This is the night. A fat kid on a pudding cup?
Yeah.
Fair enough.
That'll work. Bella
Note. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a preview of the motion picture event soon to be seen in this theater.
This is a preview of the motion picture event soon to be seen in this theater. Did they think they were coming to see it right then? Like, yeah. What else would a preview be?
They're like, don't move. We're going to be here in about 2 weeks. Just get comfortable.
Camp out. It's going to be worth it.
Take your shoes off, hell.
We would like to show you and tell you something about Walt Disney's Lady and the Tramp.
We would like to show you and tell you something about... Why don't you just show us and tell us? Yeah. Why are you going to tell us that you're going to show us and tell us? Just show us and tell us. Come on, Disney.
It's his happiest motion picture.
No. Duh.
It's his happiest motion picture. I think prior to this, there was like Cinderella and Sleeping Beauty. So I guess compared to, you know, non-consensual kisses and stuff like this, a dog movie is probably the happiest.
See, this another thing is this is like the progression of movies as far as like, oh, this is a wholesome Walt Disney movie. He's all like, I'm fixing to tell you and show you about this movie, and you're going to sit and watch it. And at least the Rocky Horror Picture Show was all like, I would like, if I may. I mean, the consent is at least in the Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Right.
No, you watch a cartoon about dogs, and you're going to like it.
Yeah, they really don't give a shit about consent in the 50s, let's be honest.
Story about dogs. Open your heart and build some glowing memories as Walt Disney takes you into that wonderful world you always hoped did exist and never knew for sure.
You know, where dogs talk to each other.
The world of dogs. To anyone who's ever owned a dog.
In the arms of the angel. Walt Disney was the original Sarah McLachlan, ladies and gentlemen.
These dogs aren't missing an eye or nothing yet.
No, but he sure can cry a big old tear.
Loved a dog or just wanted a dog. This picture is yours, heart and soul. You'll meet Lady, the belle of the social set. She was beautiful, innocent, intelligent. And besides, she owned the nicest family in town.
Oh.
Lady was the catch of the season.
Lady was the catch of the season. She's not a fish. What the hell is that about?
In the 50s, you were still allowed to own people, apparently, too. That's not problematic at all.
No, not
at all.
I don't
like I can talk about this.
That is, until the day the Tramp came into her life. Tramp, soldier of fortune. The Casanova from the wrong side of the tracks who wore no man's collar.
Man, just
what
a real
they do, you're happy home. Move it over, will you, friend?
You'll meet Jock, officially known as Heather Ladd of Glencairn, of the Blue Blood Glencairns, who collected blue ribbons, silver cups, and bones.
Let me ask you something, Ogre. Did we learn any of that about him in the actual movie?
Not a damn bit of it. I didn't know that was that dog's whole name till...
Of the Glencairns.
Marty Stauffer's Wild America of this cartoon series over here just told me. I had no idea.
Oh, my gosh.
I mean, I've watched the movie, and that's not pertinent information you need whatsoever.
Not at all. And what's funny, you'll see throughout this whole trailer, first of all, the trailer is like 4 minutes. When do they do 4-minute trailers anymore?
It's the damn movie. They cut out all the songs and BS, and they're like, here, you should have just Stayed for the trailer.
But what's funny is they introduce all these characters like they're main characters, and when you watch the movie, they're not. But anyway, here we go.
That's a grand sight.
There's Faithful Trusty, the bloodhound of the Old South, but now given to dreams of faded glories. And there are the rollicking, roistering boys in the back room down at the dog pound. Boris, remnant of the old aristocracy, who was...
All right, so here's where we begin our racist dive into this movie and things Disney, because holy cow. First of all, here we got Boris, right? Check out this accent.
On evil days.
He's like Gorky says in Lower Depths, quote, miserable being must find more miserable being. Then he's happy.
Pedro, whose visa and luck ran out at the same time.
Pedro, whose visa and luck ran out at the same time. It gets worse.
Mm. Hey, sister, Rosita, Chiquita, Juanita, Chihuahua.
And Peg. Oh, slightly shop-worn soubrette from the Dog and Pony Follies.
Slightly shop-worn.
Slightly shop-worn soubrette. What is a soubrette?
I guess it's a slut dog.
If we use our context clues, that's what we're going to go with.
This cartoon dog is drawn so strung out that the picture of her smells.
And look, even in that, where I've paused right there, she's all half-lidded. You know she's had a rough...
She's on smack. I didn't want to say it, but yeah, well, she got track that. Marks between her paws. She got little tracks on her toe beans.
Who knew many things? One of them... How to sell a song.
If he's how to sell a song. She shakes her ass. That's how she's selling it.
That's not all she's been selling.
She got to pay for that doggy heroin somehow.
She's definitely a cartoon hooker dog. She's in lockup.
Yep. Look at her shaking her tail feathers.
Yeah.
Okay.
That scene makes me just want to look for a piss puddle. You know she left
you smell one
somewhere.
One.
Yeah.
Ugh. Just watching it, you smell dog pee.
It smells like piss. I know it.
Yep.
Nobody's right. Adopting that dog.
Now, look, we're about to get into it here with Mr. Beaver, and I'm just going to say this. Ogre, please don't give away any of the same priceless content that you contributed to our full-length rundown of this movie, because... If you want beaver jokes, we got them.
The eager beaver.
6 foot 16 inches.
Oh, my God. Okay. Now, we all know that one of the most problematic things from Lady and the Tramp is the Siamese cat deal, right?
But why?
Yeah. Okay. Listen to how they originally introduced these characters.
And a pair of mischievous Orientals, Cy and Am.
We are Siamese, if you please. We are Siamese, if you don't please.
It's Easter, it's Christmas, it's New Year's Eve. All the merry celebrations.
It's everything you want.
In a movie about nothing.
As Lady talking dog.
Take you into their enchanted world.
It's all in fun.
Yeah, it's
never
not,
mind the racism. It's just all in.
It's
can't
the whole
you take
damn
a joke?
Movie. That was the entire movie without the songs.
Yeah, it pretty much summed it up. But it's killing me. This stuff they put at the end. It's all in fun. In other words, take a joke, bitch.
Yeah.
It's all in Technicolor. All in CinemaScope.
Holy snaps.
All infinitely warm and wonderful, as long as you're middle class and white.
Mm-hmm.
Walt Disney's Lady and the Tramp. It's his happiest motion picture.
This movie is pretty much just Billy Joel's Uptown Girl. Just go to YouTube and watch that video, and you saved yourself a lot of hassle.
He makes a valid point, folks. In any case, that's a little taste of what you're going to get. When you watch, Be Kind, Don't Rewind.
This has been a Studio Jester production.